Good afternoon. Today I'm going to show you how to run an XTT assay. To begin, you're going to want to set the parameters on the 96-well plate for the plate reading spectrophotometer. To do this, open up the Gen 5 microplate reading software and you'll get this task manager screen. On the task manager screen, you will select XTT assay protocol as well as my name, your host, Husra. After that, you can hit OK. And you'll get the last used setup, however, that's not going to be the same setup that we are using. So you'll scroll up over here to plate layout, and this is how you select how your plate is going to be designed. If you look at the current plate that we are working with, we only have C through E, 3 through 6 with our samples. Everything else is a blank. So to set this up, you will select blank right over here. And I always just start off by making everything a blank to make sure I don't miss anything. After you've successfully completed that, you'll scroll down to sample, SPL1 is going to be the first one, and then you'll highlight all of the designated wells. So for example, we have C3 right here, and we'll just go down C, D, and E, 3, 4, 5, and 6. That's all you'll have to do there, and then you'll hit OK. You'll hit OK again. And after that, you want to make sure that you're set to read to delta. What delta does, it takes the absorbance of the two different values and it subtracts them to avoid all of the background. And those values are going to be important later on whenever you're writing your plate. Next, you're going to want to make sure that the plate reader is turned on. To do this, there is an on switch on the right-hand side of the machine. You'll press it on. It'll take a few moments for it to turn on. It'll do its startup sequence. So give that a moment to start up. While you're waiting for it to start up, you can open the door and you can set your plate in here. You'll just slide it on the plate reader like so. Make sure that the lid is still securely fastened and then you will shut it. You will wait until the plate reader says ready before you can start. As you can see, it is ready to go. After the plate reader is ready, you are ready to begin. You're going to want to run an XTT assay before you put dye in it, so hour zero before dye, as well as hour zero immediately after you added dye to your sample. In class, we are going to run an XTT assay for hours 5, and we are going to compare that with all 4 of our sections. So to begin, you'll hit this green Read Now button and select that, and you'll be given 2 prompts. The first prompt will tell you to insert the plate, which we have already done, so you can hit OK. The plate reader is now detecting whether or not you've inserted your plate, and then it's going to ask you if you are ready to begin. Once you've placed it and it's ready to go, you will hit OK again. You will now hear the plate reader start reading your samples, which will take just a few moments. Alrighty. After your plate reader is done, you will get this warning message. You are okay just to hit OK to that. And this is what your plate reader should look like whenever you're done. As you see, your samples are going to be a very dark blue, and all of your blanks are just going to be that light blue background. You want to make sure to export all of your data into an Excel file. To do this, you'll hit the Edit Matrix button right here, the little Excel figure. You'll click that, and then you'll have the Excel pop-up down here. And then this is what you're going to see. I always make sure to label everything that I'm working with. So what I can do with this is I can say that this is hour zero and then without dye. And that's everything. Make sure to save and you're good to go.